In this lecture, we're going to talk about the second arithmetic operation, which is multiplication. When working with whole numbers, you can think of multiplication as repeated addition. So without addition, we do not have multiplication. Multiplication is also a binary operation and will be denoted by this cross sign or the X sign, or sometimes with a little dot. And it also acts on two objects with some specific rules. Let's just look at the following. If you lay down two rows of three objects, we can write that as 2 times 3. So 2 times 3, we're going to interpret that as two rows of three objects, which is basically 3 plus 3 or 6. We can also look at 3 times 2. So that would be what? 3 rows of 2 objects. So that would be 3 times 2. Or that would be the same as 2 plus 2 plus 2, 3 times, which will give me 6. So you can see how with whole numbers, multiplication is really repeated addition. So if we're working with at least one positive quantity, then you can think of it as repeated addition like we saw here. The objects themselves are called multiplicative factors or just factors. So for example here, 2 is a factor of 6. 3 is a factor of 6. Same thing here, 3 is a factor of 6. So 2 and 3 are called multiplicative factors or factors of 6. And 6, the result of the multiplication, is called the product of 2 and 3. So product of 2 and 3 is 6. So again, the multiplication symbol is this, or sometimes people will write a little dot between two objects, or the variables will appear side by side with no symbol, and that means multiplication. You saw some of this when we were doing exponents in the module 1. So some other notations, let's just get familiar with them. Okay, and this is what it means. 2 times 3 is 3 plus 3, 3 times 2 is 2 plus 2 plus 2. What do you think is the difference between 2 to the third and 3 times 2? So let's take a look. 2 to the third, we saw that an exponent base is 2. 3 is exponent. It means 2 times 2 times 2, 3 times. Whereas 3 times 2 means 2 plus 2 plus 2, 3 times. So adding 2 3 times gives us 3 times 2. Multiplying 2 3 times by itself will give you 2 to the power of 3. It's very, very important that you learn to distinguish between that and that. 2 to the power of 3 is 3 twos multiplied together. Whereas 3 times 2, that is 2 plus 2 plus 2. Very, very important. All right, let's talk about commutative property of multiplication. We know 2 times 3 is 2 rows of 3 objects. We can also write 3 times 2 as 3 rows of 2 objects. Both of those giving us 6 as the product. And this property where 2 times 3 is equaling 3 times 2 is called commutative property of multiplication. This property is true not just for whole numbers, but for all the mathematical objects we've studied so far. So A times B equals B times A, or AB equals BA. In other words, changing the order in which you multiply does not change the final result or the final product. So again, make sure you know what terminology we are working with. Multiplication is commutative, means you can change the order in which you multiply and still get the same result. Let's look at associative property of multiplication. 3 times 2 times 4. So if 4 apples this many times, this many rows of 4 apples. So 6 rows of 4 apples. Okay, what happens if I do this? Well, 2 times 4 means what? I have 2 rows of 4 apples, but then I want to lay those 3 times. So take a look. 2 rows of 4 apples, but then 3 times. Okay, same number of apples, right? All right, so let's formally word it then. So if A, B, and C represent any 3 mathematical objects, not just the whole numbers, then if you multiply A times B first and then multiply by C, it's going to give you the same result as if you took A multiplied by the result of B multiplied by C. So the order in which you multiply does not change the final answer. So changing the grouping of the three mathematical objects in a product does not change the result. Multiplication is associative. Let's talk about multiplicative identity. So if you take 1 times 4, which is one row of 4 apples, or if you take 4 times 1, which is 4 rows of 1 apple, either way you have 4 apples. So in general then, we're going to say 1 is our multiplicative identity for all the objects that we've studied so far, because 1 times A equals A times 1 equals A. In general then, multiplicative identity is an object that multiplied by all the objects in the set leave the object unchanged. In our case, it's going to be 1. 1 is multiplicative identity. Let's talk about distributive property of multiplication over addition. We are going to insist that you cannot just say distributive property. You must use all of those words. It will avoid you making mistakes. So let's first just see what the property is. Let's look at 4 times 3 plus 2. What does that mean to you? 4 rows of objects, how many? 3 objects and 2 objects together. So 3 objects, 2 objects, 4 times laid out in a row like that. So let's do that. Okay, so we have 4 rows of 3 plus 2 objects laid out like that. And that will give you what? 4 times 3, which is this part here, right? See how that's this part here? So 4 times 3. And then 4 times 2. So you can see how we're just taking that and splitting it. So giving us 20 objects total. So when you have 4 times 3 plus 2, you can rewrite it as 4 times 3 plus 4 times 2. What we're saying is that this multiplication is jumping over the addition. So 4 times 3 and plus 4 times 2. Multiplication distributes over addition. That's what that means. Let's take a look at this. So we have 5 rows of 4 objects in it. 3 plus 2, 5 rows of 4 objects. It's also the same as 3 times 4, 3 rows of 4 objects, and then 2 rows of 4 objects. And you see? So 20, look, both times we got 20. So multiplication distributes over addition from the left or from the right, it doesn't matter. And we should have expected that because our multiplication is commutative. All right, so formally, what does that mean? We say if A, B, and C represent any three mathematical objects we've studied so far, then A times B plus C is the same as A times B plus A times C. Or another way to say is A times B plus C is AB plus AC. Same thing here, except now we're multiplying by A from the right side. And same thing. So we can distribute multiplication over addition of two or more summons. So let's say I ask you to do this. There will be A times B plus A times C plus A times D plus A times C. Doesn't really matter how many objects you have here. Same thing from the other side. So multiplication distributes over addition. This is very, very important to remember. Here's your video log questions.